When mentioning the name Dante Alighieri, or Dante, most people picture the iconic portrait painted by the end of the 15th century by Sandro Botticelli. A man in a crimson gown and a laurel wreath round his head. Sounds familiar? Botticelli was the artist who was so inspired by the works of Dante Alighieri that he decided to capture the person that he was through his art. However, if you have never heard of Dante before, do not worry. Make sure to continue watching this video to find out more about his early life, including romance, love, grief, and marriage, as well as how he became one of the best writers of all time and what influence he had on the world of literature and even art. Before we start, make sure to hit the subscribe button for more videos like this one. And now, let's start. Who was Dante? Now, unfortunately, there are not many facts we know about Dante's early life, but what we do know is that Dante, full name Dante da Alighiero degli Alighieri, was a medieval Italian poet born in Florence, Italy, around the year of 1265, as the exact date is unknown. Dante's family was a supporter of the Guelphs, which were a party supporting the Pope, fighting against Ghibellines, the opposite party supporting the Holy Roman Emperor, and wanted the Pope to rule religious as well as non-religious factions. Dante's mother passed away in his early childhood, and it is thought that his father, Alighiero, remarried and had two more children, giving Dante a sister, Tana, and a brother, Francesco. As for Dante, this was the time where arranged marriages were very common, so he would have to marry whoever his family decided was the best fit for him. Dante fell in love with a girl named Beatrice Portinari at the age of 9, even though he had only seen her once and didn't even exchange a conversation. Regardless, he had to marry someone else at the age of 12. This sounds ridiculous now, but it was very common during the medieval times. Well, Dante never had the chance to get to know Beatrice, so she remained as the romanticized love at first sight for him. This is why many assume that she is the main muse and inspiration for his poems, which would not be a surprise. Artists are usually hopeless romantics, aren't they? But in spite of his dedicated love for a girl he had only met once, he had three children, Pietro, Jacopo, and Antonia, in his arranged marriage with a woman named Gemma from the Donati family. As mentioned before, Dante was a member of a political family supporting the Guelphs. Dante even took part in the Battle of Campaldino in the summer of 1289 that ended in victory for the Guelphs. After this, he became a member of the city council. It might sound surprising, but during his political career, he started to practice pharmacy. However, back in the days, this was not an uncommon thing. In order for Dante to have been a public figure, he must have had to gone through Della Arti e dei Mesteri, so he chose to join the Apothecaries Guild, as books were sold at apothecary shops back then. Despite his efforts, his political career did not last too long. After the split of the Guelphs, Dante sided with the White Alliance and faced exile from Florence, as well as a huge fine from the opposite Black Alliance, who accused Dante of financial misconduct and corruption. At first, he refused and decided to stay, which is why he received a heavier fine, but he was soon forced to start living in different parts of northern Italy. He found shelter in Lunigiana, where he started working on the masterpiece, that is, the Divine Comedy. But we will get into that further in the video, so make sure to stick around. Dante's work and inspiration. Dante spent a lot of time with his contemporary poets and literaries, such as Brunetto Latini, Lapo Gianni, Cino da Pistoia, and Guido Cavalcanti, who were influenced by classical writers such as Cicero, Aristotle, Ovid, Virgil, etc. When he started writing poems, sonnets, as well as songs in Italian instead of Latin, even though it was highly unconventional at the time. So this marked an important moment in the history of Italian literature, as his successors would follow his footsteps and choose writing in Italian over creating work in Latin. However, despite the fact that Dante and his peers studied classical antiquity, Tuscan poetry, and much more, his main inspiration remains his first love, Beatrice Portinari. The most famous piece of work by Dante, which is of course La Commedia or The Divine Comedy, was not his first experience of writing. Between the years 1292 to 1294, he wrote The New Life or Vita Nuova in Italian for his first love, Beatrice, after she passed away in the year of 1290. It is a prosimetrum, meaning it is written in both verse and prose at the same time, which was not very rare for Dante. He himself referred to it as Libello, Italian for the little book. This Libello included 42 chapters, where you could find sonnets, ballads, and some unfinished ideas as well, which can be thought to symbolize his unfinished relationship with Beatrice. In this story, we follow Dante's love story from the very beginning, from when he met 8-year-old Beatrice when he was 9, to the day of her death. It follows the medieval literary concept of courtly love, a fictional love story created for entertainment of the nobles. A famous quote from The New Life you might have heard before is that he swore to write a story that which has never been written of any woman. Later on, he would go on to write Convivio in Italian or The Banquet, translated to English, 1304. Unlike The New Life, this piece of prosimetrum touches upon many different aspects of life, mainly themes like history, politics, and philosophy, rather than love and romance. His collections of poems include works like De Vulgari Eloquentia, Italian for Eloquence in the Vernacular Tongue, which was written in the year of 1304. You may have also heard of De Monarchia, On the Monarchy, written in 1309, and Epistole, Italian for Letters, created in 1313. With all of the listed works and more, Dante managed to not only inspire contemporary writers, but future artists as well. For example, the famous Italian painter of the Renaissance period, Sandro Botticelli. He not only created the famous portrait of Dante, which we mentioned at the beginning of this video, but he also depicted the Divine Comedy for an Italian banker, Lorenzo di Pierfrancesco, where he portrayed life in the underworld. Dante also inspired the painting Canto 8 by Giovanni Stradano, as well as the artist William Blake. The Divine Comedy. And we have come to the moment you have been waiting for. The Divine Comedy, translated from Commedia Divina, was originally named simply Comedy but received the title of Divine from Boccaccio after being considered as one of the greatest pieces of Italian literature. Written from 1308 and completed in 1321, this three-part narrative poem was written over 10 years and can be considered to be one of the greatest love stories of all time. But apart from the themes of romance and intense love, one of the main reasons The Divine Comedy became so popular is because of its incredibly graphic descriptions of heaven and hell. One of the recurring images are exactly these violent and bleak scenes that make it stand out from anything that had been written before that time. Dante depicted the following on a gate to hell in history: "All hope abandon, ye who enter here." Yes, it is that intense. Throughout the storyline, Dante depicts himself as the main character, starting from the very first part, Inferno, where he takes us on his very bleak journey through hell. In the second part, which is called Purgatorio, Beatrice, yes, Dante's first love, appears as a holy character, a heavenly figure guiding him through purgatory. Part 3 is Paradiso, or Paradise, you guessed it. Here he reaches heaven. Apart from these two main themes, it is also clear that he touches upon his time in politics while living in Florence. Besides Dante believing in God, he came across as quite critical throughout the Divine Comedy towards the Church, as he wanted Florence to gain more independence and freedom from Roman influence. Being in exile made him reach a point where, instead of being silenced by the opposite Black Party, he wrote one of the best pieces of literature that we still talk about centuries later. It is clear that it's written from his perspective and is aimed to be read by the White Party, as he illustrates scenes of the Black Party members being tortured and burned, with main themes of love, sin and redemption through hell, purgatory, and heaven. Dante created a masterpiece which brought him the title of the father of the Italian language, therefore became a huge influence on artists, poets, and painters to follow. Dante's two burials. Dante lived for 56 years. In the year of 1321, he was on his way back to Ravenna from Venice, where he contracted malaria and passed away in Ravenna, his new hometown, region in northern Italy, where he was buried at the church of San Pier Maggiore. His tombstone reads, "Florence, mother of little love," which made Florence feel guilty for ever making him leave and wanted to bury him in his actual hometown, but after having been refused, they built the beautiful cenotaph regardless. It reads, "Honor the most exalted poet," which can be found in the Basilica of Santa Croce in Florence. Dante's body, however, remains in Ravenna, and 700 years later, Florence apologized for ever forcing him into exile. 700 years. You heard that right. With a traumatizing childhood that included his mother's death, a remarried father, half-siblings, and unrequited love, Dante became one of the most impactful literary personas of all time. There is no doubt that he changed the landscape of Italian literature forever by utilizing his past trauma and experiences to create the Divine Comedy that remains a truly exceptional story. We hope that we gave you an insight to Dante's interesting life and his masterpieces, and that is a little bit more clear why Dante is referred to as the father of Italian language. Maybe we even inspired you to pick up a Dante Alighieri book. If so, let us know what you think down below. Also, make sure to check out our other videos to learn more about Italy's culture and history. Thank you for watching.